Hello, my name is Shug, and today I want to explain to you, at least those of you that don't know, what a whoopee sling is. What is a whoopee sling? This is a whoopee sling right here, an integral part of many a person's hammock suspension components. So the whoopee sling is running right here from my tree strap. Here's the whoopee sling, which runs to what I like to use as my Dutch beaner, to my continual loop, to my hammock. Are you thoroughly confused? So let's take a little closer look at the whoopee sling, and hopefully at the end of this, you can decide if this is going to be part of your hammock suspension system. Hey, and before I go any further, let me just say this about hammock suspensions these days. Now, when I got into hammocking, it was a lot easier. There weren't that many choices. I used the whoopee sling probably 92.7.5% of the time. No particular reason. I enjoy it. I get a lot of adjustability out of it. I get to say whoopee sling a lot. So let's take a look at it today and explain a couple of ways of how you can use your whoopee slings in your hammock suspension. Okay, this is where my whoopee sling connects to my Dutch beaner, which goes down a continual loop that goes through the gathered end. I like a continual loop, and I like a Dutch beaner or something to act as a water break in case water runs down the whoopee sling. Now we look at the whoopee sling as it continues on up. Right, and now we're at the part of the whoopee sling that is called the berry. Here you can see the dangling end coming out where the whoopee sling goes inside of itself in this berry right here. All right, and it comes out right there. And that goes on up. Bida 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 bing, up to my toggle and my strap on what is called a Marlin spike toggle system, which would then go on out to my tree, but in this case, it's an eye hook in my studio. But here's how it works. So I have this loose end here, and this is just all leftover whoopee sling, and it can slide up inside of itself. So what I'm doing is I'm pulling that end through this berry right here. But you can see, lets my hammock go way down. And I've got it pulled all the way, almost all the way out now, and have this huge loop, which I will then hang on my Marlin spike toggle. Remember, hang on the knot, not on the toggle. Now I'll take that end of the whoopee sling, and now I'm pulling it up through itself. This way, I can bring my hammock up to the height I want. Always, always double check to make sure that your whoopee sling end is sitting on your knot well if you're going to use a Marlin spike toggle type of configuration. Now my hammock is where I want it. And what I'm going to do now, just to make sure that the whoopee sling doesn't slide a lot of people, I'm going to do what's called milking the berry. You know, if you don't milk your berry, you got to be wary of yourself falling down on your derriere. All right, let's explain that milking the berry again. So I'm going to pull that. I reach right up here. I can see the end that I need to pull. I'll pull some out. Make sure it's on the toggle good. Now my berry ends up down here. So I start pulling to bring my hammock to the proper height. And pull some more. Okay, now I've got my hammock to where I want, and I've been compressing that berry up like this. And the berry, oh, you can see it's sort of packed up against itself. And what I want to do is just run my fingers down it, and you kind of see it stretching out a little bit. It's like those old Chinese handcuffs, they used to call them, where you'd have this straw thing, you put your fingers in the end and pull. That's what your berry is doing right there. So if you don't milk your berry, you can see, watch this berry as I pull. You'll see it kind of compress up on itself a little bit. And then when I milk it, watch how it sort of lengthens a little bit right here. I don't know if that was quite obvious, but milking your berry is just pulling on that berry a couple of times to make sure when you get in your hammock, this does not slide up that way. Now you'll notice on the whoopee sling, you might have seen it in there, there's a little ring on the part of the whoopee that that adjusts. It gets smaller and bigger. Sometimes there's a bead there. Now, people ask what that's for. Well, I'm going to show you. As we pull that in, all right, and extend that whoopee, fairly soon, what's going to happen is that loop is going to pull, see that, inside of the constrictor. Now, when that happens, it's a real pain. So if you have a bead on there or a little ring like that, it gives you a little time to, you know, get that pulled back out. This particular whoopee sling has a 5.5 inch, probably what you would call a 6 inch berry. You know, a whoopee sling is made out of, most of them are, it will support about 1,000 pounds. It's 7/64 AM steel, super strong stuff. But we're going to show you how you can just hook your whoopee sling suspension straight to the end of your hammock if you're a person that doesn't want to use any hardware and you're a purist. Now here's a continual loop on my Green Bean, the new 0.20. Now I've got my continual loop just looped, lark's headed around my whipping here. And this is a different style of whipping. That holds the whipping together. And that also keeps that continual loop from sliding. And then that would just hook right to, the way I always do it, that would just go right into my Dutch beaner right there. Which I like because it sits under the end of my tarp. Usually the end of my tarp is out here. And if any water tends to run in, it hits this and drips away rather than running down to my hammock. Okay, on a whoopee sling, this is your fixed end right here. This doesn't slide back and forth. This is the part that was hooked into that Dutch beaner, all right? And we're going to look at that of hooking that directly to the end of your hammock, all right? Now, they're usually a small loop. That's not a very big loop. So the easiest way to do it is do a lark's head. And that is just pulling I just pull it through the loop, doing that kind of a thing right there. Easy, easiest knot there is. Then I would just take my hammock, all right, slide that over the end of the hammock. Just make sure that it's got something to grab it, and there it is right there. That way, the end of your whoopee sling, that end, is going directly to your hammock, and now you take the loose end, or the end that opens up into a bigger loop as you pull it, and hook that out into your preferred suspension method. For me, a toggle. So now we just take that end and we just hook it directly to our toggle and marlin spike right there. Now let me hook it back up and show you how the free end here can also be used as a water break. Our whoopee sling is hooked directly to the end of the hammock, on up to the toggle up toward the tree strap. Now here's your free end. And what you can do with that is, if the water runs under your tarp and starts coming down the whoopee sling, in theory it should hit here and drip down. But sometimes it will go over the top. Best way to do it is just take that loose end, which is just dangling free here, and just take some of it as close to the end of your hammock as you can right here, you know, 2 inches back. Just sort of tie a knot, all right? So now you got this, and you got this knot right here as a redundancy knot to stop the water running down before it hits your hammock and gets the end of your hammock wet. You're welcome. Okay, so I got a different whoopee sling here. When they put the whoopee together, they add this to it, and this is called a Dutch whoopee hook. And what this does is that hooks to your continual loop on the end of your hammock whipping. And it takes place of using a Dutch beaner or some other kind of hardware on there. It works as a water break. There's your whoopee hook. Goes on up your suspension, up to the toggle, and hooks right here on the continual loop that goes to the end of your hammock whipping. And again, the nice thing about a system like this is as the water runs down the line, it's going to hit this, and this will act as a water break to keep it from running to your hammock. And, you know, that it grabs your Amsteel pretty nicely, but you can unhook your hammock very easily that way and then hook it back on. Boom. You're safe and secure. And that is called the whoopee hook. Whoopee slings generally come in a length of around 6 feet. And this is the whoopee sling. All right, here's the end where the berry is. Here's your constrictor, or your berry part. There's your free end. And we have your whole whoopee loop going all the way out right here. And this is it in its longest form of about 6 feet. So now what I'll do is I'll draw it in. All right, we're shortening it here. And I'll draw it in almost to the point that the loop gets sucked up into the berry. There's your fixed end. There is your adjustable end, almost pulled in. And you see we're at about 16 inches there at its shortest. So you have a lot of adjustability, and a lot of that also depends on the amount of strap you have here. This looks to be about a 4 foot strap. I have some 6 foot straps, some 7 foot straps, some 5 foot straps. I could hang the whoopee sling off the very end of the strap, adding myself 4 or 5 feet. Or if I use a toggle, I'm able to tie this toggle up or down the strap toward the end. And what that will do is give me a little bit more distance or take in some distance. So what I like about the Marlin Spike Hitch toggle tree strap, and I have a video on this, a real short one. I'll put a link to it right here, but I think it's just called How to Tie a Marlin Spike Hitch. I can move it anywhere up or down. So if I've got a hang where I know I don't want all this extra strap, I tie the Marlin Spike up pretty close to the end of the strap. Put my toggle in there, bam. All right, let's just say I need this much more line. Let's come to the end of the line and tie my Marlin Spike knot as close to the end as I can. And now I've got a lot of extra line there. Then I hook my whoopee sling on that out to my hammock. So, you know, getting that distance with any suspension between your trees and your hammock, depending on the length of your hammock, 10-foot hammock, 11-foot hammock, you got a 12-foot hammock. I look for trees that are 15 to 17 feet apart for the most part. I prefer them really far apart, but sometimes I get a hang that's really tight, and I've been known to use a whoopee sling on one side and then actually just take my continual loop and hook it over my toggle on my tree strap. So, you know, you got to get creative out there. There's no right or wrong in suspensions. Whatever suspension and option you choose to use, you choose to use, you choose to use, you choose to use, you choose to use. That's up to you. That'll end up being your suspension. You'll really like it. Now let's look at how we'll hang that whoopee hook suspension, which normally, if you go to Dutch's site, it's all built into the tree strap, okay? So we'll look and see how that figures into the end there and how that works. Actually, the whoopee hook is going to hook to a continual loop like this. Goes up right here. There's your berry. And then it hooks on the end of a tree strap like this, just sort of lark's headed through up to your tree strap. What happens though is it's connected, and in this case I don't have quite enough space to get that hammock up as high as I want right here. So here's what I got to do. So what I did that time was just loop my strap around the tree an extra time, have it come through my carabiner, and that shortens it up enough that gets it to the height that I want it to be. Now keep in mind with any suspension system, the length of your straps, the width of the trees where you are, the width of the tree, and by that I mean the diameter, is it this big around, is it this big around? That all comes into play when you're doing your suspension, so I can't answer every question on that because I don't know what it's gonna be like when you're out there, but you know, this is where hammocks are fun and you gotta play around a little bit. Now with my regular whoopee sling, I have it going to my Dutch beaner. Here's where I adjust. Here's my berry. It goes up to my toggle. As you can see, it is sitting on the knot and not hanging off the toggle, up to my tree strap. And again, you don't want your strap pulling across the tree at this angle. creates a lot of stress on the carabiner and the strap. But if we get it pulling this way, there's not very much stress right here. Okay, just keep that in mind. Comes down, boom. Whoopee slings are light, they're a little less bulky than straps, but I often say, if you're looking to save weight in your hammock system, suspension's not usually the place. I mean, you'll save a few grams here or there, but try to find other places to save big weight. Hope it helped you out. I mean, all secure in Sector 7. Woo, buddy! Oh yeah, and lest I forget, information on where you can get a whoopee sling, where you can buy a whoopee sling, where you can buy a whoopee hook, it's all in the description box below this video. I'll put a few links right there for you. A lot of people like making their own. I know there's instructions on YouTube and online, so just go to Google or one of your search engine and type in how to make a whoopee sling, because that's the way I type. So one whoopee sling by itself is 20 grams, which is 0.7 of an ounce. Whoopee sling! Ching chang walla walla bing ding! Whoopee sling.